Hey guys, my name is Adrian Reddix, and in this video, I'm talking about these LG Tone Style HBS SL5s. I know that's a lot of jargon, but these are wireless headphones or a wireless headset. And I know if you watch my video from a couple videos ago, you would see that I made a case for, is that a night? A moth? What is that? I made a case for that the 3.5 millimeter jack is still relevant. And I still do think that, but if you don't have a 3.5 millimeter jack in your phone, if you have anything newer than 2000 and I don't know, 16, 17, you probably don't. Wireless headphones are an option, right? Or the only option. Unless you get some of those headphones that have a USB-C in instead of a TRS plug or a lightning connector or whatever the charging port is on that. So the LG Tones, I got the first LG Tone when I worked at a authorized retailer of Verizon that may be located in Knoxville. What we used to do is we used to take the LG Tones, we bought them ourselves, and my manager at the time told me, hey, I'll put a picture up of me wearing them. You know, use your accessories. That's something that you can show the customer, hey, you're actually using this accessory. And, you know, if it's good and you can talk more about it, it's a basic sales thing. You need to use and understand your product before you can sell it. That's just what it is. I got the Tones and I loved them. The thing about the first generation of Tones, it had buttons everywhere. It was buttons all up and down this side and all up and down that side. You control the phone on one side and then you control all the music and other things on the other side. It was too many buttons. With this one, you have three buttons, and these three buttons take care of everything. Power, calls, volume, skip tracks, rewind, all that. Now, who needs these things? People that don't want earbuds. That's really the demographic. If you don't want earbuds, that's it. Also, with earbuds, you have a issue where, yeah, you have them in all the time, but you have to keep the case with you. So to charge them, you know, I know it's wireless charging, but you still have to have the case. So you're still carrying two things around. With this form factor, it's all here. You don't have to carry something with it. You know, you still have to have a charger, of course. On the box that it comes in, it says that it can give you a 3-hour charge in 10 minutes. I found in my testing, it was about right. It varies a little bit, you know, based on cable and other factors, but it's about there. As far as sound quality, it was very balanced. LG teams up with Meridian. Meridian is a British audio company. They do some really high-end speakers and things like that. So audio is something they know, and they did a great job on the audio on this. It was really, really good. I'll give you this story. As far as range, you know, it's Bluetooth, so range is about 35 feet. But it also depends on how much space there is and what's between you and the phone, or between the headset and the phone, or whatever device you're using it on. So I go to the gym every day. I know if you look at my face and this gut, you can't tell. So I go to the gym every day. I usually set a timer. So when I get done with the treadmill, I get off and I start doing weights. I'll alternate different muscle groups like you're supposed to. I was doing legs that day. So I got off the treadmill, went over to the hip abductor or hip deductor. It was one of the hip machines that go like this. So I'm working my way, doing like my little mini circuit, and I got to the leg press machine and I'm knocking it out, and I find that my alarm's going off because it'll go silent when the alarm goes off. So I'm looking in my pockets. I'm like, where's my phone? And I went back to every machine to look and see where my phone was. And it ended up being at that first machine way over 35 feet away. And I couldn't tell the difference. I mean, the sound didn't drop out. There was no quality issues. There was no nothing. It didn't even give me a warning, which it will warn you when you get out of range, that, hey, you're out of range, and it'll buzz. Never got the warning. But that's just the nature of Bluetooth. I just wanted to share that anecdote with you. LG has a app. And if you go to at least the Apple App Store, the LG app is not rated so high. It has a rating of, let's check this out. It has a rating of 1.4. And I was like, come on, this is just, it can't be that bad. If you look at some reviews, you have people wishing for 0-star ratings. And so I downloaded it to see how bad or how misinformed some of these people were. I'm happy to report that they were not misinformed. It is a very horrible app. For such a good product, the companion app is terrible. Let's say right now I have the tones connected. As you can see by the, let's get closer. I don't know if you can see it. I might have to, let's adjust this a little bit. We're gonna do manual focus. As you can see, I'll do a screen recording. 1 second, let me get my glasses. Let me get my glasses. Yeah. Let me get my glasses. Okay. All right. As you can see with the, I'll put it up on the screen because it didn't really want to focus, that the headphones are connected to the phone. But you have to use the app, you have to disconnect them, reconnect them, and then right after you reconnect, you have to go open up the app so it can see it. I don't know if it's some type of timeout procedure or something, but it's horrible. It's not, why do I have to disc, if it's connected to the phone, why do I have to disconnect it? I couldn't get it to work every other time I've ever tried to do it. I had to disconnect it and then reconnect and then immediately go to the app and then hit connect before it could find it. Weird. But once you get into it, it has things that tells you, hey, it's connected, how much battery it has. If you look at the top of, on the iOS, the phone already tells you how much battery you have. And when you have the buds in your ear and you turn it on to connect it, it tells you, hey, battery medium, battery low. I get a lot of battery medium. Battery high. I mean, it tells you everything you need to know right then and there. I don't know why this exists, but it does have these equalizer settings. And let me tell you, these equalizer settings are horrible. I thought the sound was good. I'll take that back. They're not horrible. The bass one, because I'm a very bass heavy person. Again, I'm not an audiophile or I'm not an audio expert, but the bass sounded very good. And it went down to normal. It kind of, I understand they take some of the bass out, but when you go down the treble, the treble sounded very, very tinny. It was just, it wasn't good. As far as audio, I don't know why you would have any of these presets. And if they would have said, what would have made the app better? If one, you could connect, or it would see the connection no matter how long the app's not been working. Two, being that you worked with Meridian, I know that Meridian has access to a bunch of audio engineers or artists where you could say, hey, let's get this artist to make custom preset that you can use, and it would bring out certain tones and certain levels. That would have been awesome, but they didn't. They just created an app that sucked. Just what it is. As far as the fit in the ear, it's quite comfortable. Of course, just like every other thing that comes with earbuds, you have these gels that you can pop on and pop off to get a custom fit. And as far as noise, the fit is really, really good. And there wasn't a lot of noise leak inside of my ear. If I didn't try the app, it would be a fantastic experience. But the app brings that experience down. So if you ever get LG Tones, until they do better with the app itself, don't download it. It's horrible. Don't do it. The sound reproduction on it is fantastic. I listen to music on a couple different headphones, and as far as accuracy, to me, it's fairly accurate as far as sound. The only thing about these headphones or these tones that I don't like is the price. As you know, I'm pretty frugal. I like to call myself cheap. And at anywhere between $99 to $130, it's right there in line with all the other AirPods, with a lot of other wireless headphones. So as far as that, it's right there. But again, you know me, I'm cheap, and I would like to see if I can find a cheaper brand with the same quality. But as you've heard many times before, you pay for what you get. Would I recommend this to anybody to buy? Only if you don't like the idea of just having just your audio equipment just in your ear all the time. With this, I don't have to worry about losing. I don't like things in my ear all the time. I just don't. So I have to worry about losing this. It's here. It's around my neck. As long as I don't lose my neck, I'm not going to lose these tones. Well, that's about it. If you like this video, please hit the like button, comment, subscribe to the channel. I do these every week. I'll catch you guys in the next one. See you later.